الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. You don't put someone on the spot and tell him to read something, because Quran requires preparation regardless how much you know and how much you memorize. It's not easy. But ask me, why do I do that? Go ahead, ask.
Why?
Why? Thank you for asking. Because I want to put you under pressure so you know what pressure is and how to react, and that builds your character. I guarantee you next time he's going to feel a lot better than what he's feeling now. He's feeling good now, and he should be feeling good now. Because look at that Abdullah guy. See him? He's doing nothing. You are here. Everybody, the whole school is looking at you because you're special. So jazakallahu khayr, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. You're fasting? Stop. You are? Ta'al, ta'al, ta'al. Speaks Arabic, no? You did this. Jazakallahu khayr. Be quiet. Supposed to be fasting. أصبحنا وأصبح الملك لله والحمد لله لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير ربي أسألك خير ما في هذا اليوم وخير ما بعده ربي أعوذ بك من شر هذا اليوم وشر ما بعده ربي أعوذ بك من الكسل وسوء الكبر رب أعوذ بك من عذاب في النار وعذاب في القبر الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Today is what of the Hijjah? The Hijjah, the Eid, أحسن. This is the day of Tarwiyah. Tarwiyah is when the Hujjaj are provided for people who would like to give the Hujjaj water, so they can have energy to go where? Mina. Where is Mina? In Mecca. See how simple that is? You were going to think, oh, the directions and all that. Mina, what do they do there? Spend Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, and Fajr. They pray Fajr. Where they go after that on the 9th, which is tomorrow? Arafat, Ahsan. That's the day we're supposed to fast, tomorrow. I know you're tomorrow off, but you're not off with working with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 1 year before, sins erased, and 1 year ahead, sins erased. Some scholars said the day of Arafah is the best day of the year because of the rewards that you get for fasting there. So you go to Arafah, you spend what? Dhuhr and Asr. And what do they do after that? What do you do in Arafah? Dua. Dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees people who are destined to be in hellfire the day of Arafah more than any other day. Forgives them, meaning that they were going to be in hell, and takes them out of that. And then, after sunset, where do you go? Muzdalifah. Do you pray Maghrib in Arafah? No. You go to Muzdalifah, but you're going to miss it. There's not enough time between Arafat and Muzdalifah. What do? You combine Maghrib and Isha. And what do you do in Muzdalifah? Nothing after Isha. You snore until morning. Pray early, pick your pebbles. How many? Well, 7. Why? Yeah, but you're not going to throw all of them. But what about if you miss one? You're going to go back to Muzdalifah and pick another one and come back? Takes you another day? You take more, right? Yeah, in case. right? Because if you throw at the pillar and you miss it and it comes completely out, that doesn't count. What do you say when you throw the pebble? La ilaha illallah, right? No. What do you say? Allah Akbar. Allahu Akbar. When you throw that, you throw it really on who, Ya Shaykh? On the shaitan, right? So the shaitan is sitting there just receiving punches. It's just to commemorate, to remember what Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam was doing. Ibrahim alayhi salam was going to slaughter his son. And that's a major thing. So the shaitan is acting good, a good friend. So he comes in the front of Ibrahim alayhi salam and he tells him, you're going to kill your son? Astaghfirullah, that your son, that your baby, this part of you. And Ibrahim alayhi salam had to listen to the shaitan or to listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a choice. Ibrahim alayhi salam takes pebbles and he throws the shaitan 7 times and then the shaitan disappears. Then he keeps going, taking his son. So he stops. Another stop. Shaitan showed up again. Did the same thing. So he threw him another 7. And the 3rd time, another 7. And that's why we're doing that. And after the 3rd time, what did he do? He slaughtered his son, right? Yes or no? Yalla ya Surah, you're looking at him just like my brother Diwan said. I'm looking at you and you go looking around you. Yes or no? No, you're right. He didn't. He was about. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَ لَمِشْرِ. Are you tough or not tough? Are you a tough person? Who's tough? تعال. I want someone to cry. فَلَمَّا أَسْلَمَ. Yeah, when both of them, Ibrahim alayhi salam decided he wants to do it, and Ismail alayhi salam accepted it, وَتَلَّهُ لِلْجَبِينِ. And he grabbed him like this because he kind of slaughtered him. I mean, you're not going to just come and say, did I miss your hand?
Yes.
Brother, look at your mind. One of the worst freeway you can ever think of. Okay. And does he kill from here or from here? Yeah, but he doesn't want to look at his face. So it doesn't matter, right? So he grabbed him like this and pulled him and ready to do it. Hold it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you fulfilled the dream. And then all you see is something next to him called man. That's man. That's water. Have you slaughtered? What's the main event of Eid? Slaughter. The best thing that you can do the day of Eid is slaughter. And what is the best time for slaughtering? How many days you have to slaughter? 4 days. Eid, which is the 10th, then 11, 12, 13, 14, until sunset. The best is the day of Eid. Because when you want to do good, what do? You do it fast. You don't delay. So we have tomorrow Arafah, make sure you fast, and then Eid, make sure you go play and forget Dhuhr and Asr and Maghrib and Isha, because today is Eid, you're having fun, you know, who cares about the Salah? Salah is when you have time, right Ibrahim? Yeah, or Mustafa, you pray whenever you feel like it, right? Why not? That's extra prayer. Extra prayer, you do it whenever you feel like it. But for what is the best thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes in these 10 days of the Hijjah? Smart people only? Huh? Fard, ahsan. Ah, this guy is good, inshallah. Fard.